Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. This is the first video and what a way to start. Apple Mac Mini M1 2021. Actually, the story is I purchased this in December 15, 2020. And today, which is 11th of January 2021, I got the delivery. And I'll tell you the story why it took so long. So let me unbox it first and I'll tell you more about this. There it is. My son helping me out. We've both been waiting for nearly a month for this. Correct. There you go. Was it worth waiting all this time? Well, we'll have to find out. Now the story is, I ordered this December 15th, 2020. After watching lots of reviews from different YouTubers, pro YouTubers, raving about this product. So I placed the order and so waited. Now the reason I waited and I couldn't pick it up from store is this is a customized version. So this is 16 gig RAM, Mac Mini M1. So there's something you need to be aware of. If you are customizing, if you're getting a 16 gig model, 16 gig RAM, then you'll have to wait, and it does take 2-3 weeks. For me, it was nearly a month, and they also lost track of it at one point. So luckily, here it is, and let's enjoy the unboxing. But the problem is, whilst I was waiting for this, I purchased after getting a good review from lots of YouTubers, but during the waiting time, same people, same YouTubers were complaining about Bluetooth. Lots of Bluetooth issues. So that's something to worry about. And then nearly a month later, same people of YouTubers, or some of the YouTubers I've been watching, they're returning their device because they just had enough of it. And me, here it is after a month or nearly a month. So hopefully I don't have any problem like them. And let's do the unboxing. There you go, my son eager to help me. All right, father and son together. Voila. Okay, hold it then. There you go. It's very small. You can see. Wow. I have to say, it's very elegant looking though. Very elegant. We know what's in there. Some paperwork and cables. That's all you get. I know that already. After watching so many reviews, I pretty much know everything. So this can go away and this is it. Look at that. Poor lighting. Apologies. Poor lighting, but this is it. This is your 16 gig model. Nicely it does it. Yes, finally. Finally. Okay. I think that needs to come off. Got all the connections here. So let's take it off. Come on. My son's going to do it. He's really eager to do everything. Okay. There you go. You know, I've watched so many reviews. I just feel like I know everything, even though I've never touched one of these before. That's the truth. So you got all the ports, HDMI, two Thunderbolts, and USB. One Ethernet and the power cable, and that's it, simple as that. And now the fan port. And you can get headphone jack as well here. There you go. Now, you saw the power cable that comes with it. It doesn't come with anything else. So I purchased separately. I purchased HDMI to HDMI cable. So this HDMI cable, this HDMI to HDMI, Ivanki model, I got it from Amazon for £5.99 UK price. The spec is, this is 4K at 60 Hz high speed HDMI. Alternatively, if I don't use the HDMI to HDMI, I might give it a go with, I also purchased this uni, and that's a USB type C to HDMI cable. So just having more options. Poor lighting. What can you do next time? But again, this is 4K at 60 Hz high refresh rate. And it's very is compatible with the MacBook Pro and iPad. So I'll choose which one I go for. We'll try give it a go. Now, this all is connected to my, it will be connected to my 27-inch BenQ. Widescreen monitor, it's a gaming monitor I have, which is already connected to Xbox S and PS4, as well as my PC. So the Xbox and PS is already connected by HDMI splitter, so that's what I can use. I'll use the HDMI splitter for my Mac Mini, and PC is connected directly to the monitor, so that's not an issue. And my HDMI splitter, it's got three connections, so two connections already used, as I said, one for the PS4 and one for the Xbox S. And now I'll use the remaining port for the Mac Mini M1. So what I'll do, stay around, let me connect it. And also I'm going to connect it with, as we know, it's a Bluetooth issues, possibly Bluetooth issues, but at the beginning you need mouse, cable mouse, and cable to keyboard. So I got them ready as well. I'm going to use my existing one, power it up, connect it, and see how it goes. Is the power cable's gone in, and I will connect it with this old Dell keyboard, wired Dell keyboard, and a basic mouse, wired mouse, and see how it goes from there. So I got most of the cable in, and I'm going to go for HDMI one. I'll try the HDMI cable first and see how it works. You can try with the other one afterwards, but I'll just use HDMI for now. And I only got 1 meter long HDMI cable. I think the shorter the better. Hopefully it should be quick response rather than getting a very long HDMI cable. So I've got all the connections there. A bit messy, but right now it's really, we're just testing it out. See, everything's working. Power switch. Okay. Mac Mini's breathing. About 5 seconds, 10 seconds. There you go. Mouse is working. Oh, yeah, UK. Yep, continue. Not now. So finally we made it. We're on the main screen. Slight issue with the login. My existing iCloud account, there was slightly issue, I don't know why. But I managed to fix it. Everything's okay. Here we are now. Yeah, looks good. So I'm a first time user of Mac OS system. Have a look at this. What is this? Okay. It's pretty fast. So, like I said, this one, 16 gig RAM, Mac Mini I got. This is because the problem with these machine is that you cannot upgrade it in future. You're pretty much stuck with what you get. So, kind of future-proofed it. Hopefully, I wouldn't need to change it for a while. It's 16 gig. Should be fairly enough as it is very fast. As all the reviews we've seen, it's very, very fast, almost 2.5, 3 times faster than normal what you get nowadays. So I'm pretty happy. Need to experience the speed though and performance. So let's see how it goes. And I think if you can wait, it's worth the extra £200 to upgrade the RAM. The RAM only. I don't think the hard disk is worth it, because you can always get external SSD drive to increase your storage. Plus, you get the iCloud. With the 16 gig RAM, you shouldn't have much performance issue. Where with 8 gigs, it's really not enough. If you look at a lot of reviews, the guys when they were using it, the RAM was hitting around 7.5 gig on the 8 gig model. And about two out of that, about 2.5 gig was swap memory. So that was using SSD anyway. Well, that's not good for the SSD because if it's regularly you need to use SSD to help it out, it's not really good. At least here, it got with 16 gig has enough memory to breathe basically. It doesn't need to. I hope it doesn't need to use the swap space that much. And rather use its own memory, and it's got plenty of that. So I'm going to use it mainly for video editing and working on Final Cut Pro. Mostly on that, and maybe some programming apps and all that, etc. But I don't think it will be too intense from my perspective, my usage. But like I said, this is my first time into Apple Mac OS. I do have an iPad Pro. So that's an iOS, slightly different. But in terms of PC, this is the first time on Mac OS. So let's see how it goes. And the price itself is very attractive. It's under £900. I got a slight discount. I got a £60 discount through my work related. So I got it under 850. So I use the extras to buy a Bluetooth keyboard and mouse, and which I will review later on or try them out. Poor lighting again. Yeah, so I'll give it a go. Looks nice. Looks like the Apple Magic Keyboard. We'll see how it works. So, advice is if you can, get the 16 gig RAM version of Mac Mini. You will be settled for a while. And all the Bluetooth issues. Worst case scenario, use a cable while a cable keyboard and a mouse. But I'm sure they will fix it. Apple will fix this kind of problem, and it shouldn't be too much of an issue. So, if you like so far what you've seen, subscribe, and there will be more to from me. more on this channel. The journey begins on this channel with Mac Mini M1. We'll see how it goes. Just if you need to know anything, just comment below. Ask me what you need to know. I hope it's been informative. I'm just another user, not a pro, not Apple fanboy or anything like that. But I do respect them. Quality is there. I mean, I can tell from my iPad Pro 11 I got last year. Completely different league. So yeah, props to them. So stay tuned, subscribe, and if you need to know anything, so just let me know, see how it goes. And I've just done this video late at night, don't have all the equipment ready. Couldn't wait. It's been nearly a month for this small thing, kept us waiting that long. So anyway, thank you for watching. Take care.